trades.
Mr. Craig, tell me a little about the hostility you were talking about building up. How much hostility builds in a place like this?
The hostility, it builds when you confine an individual 23 hours a day. All right. So when you got an individual and he don't have nothing to occupy that time, he just constantly confined to that cell, then eventually he gonna explode. So you got the individual supervisory officials, they on the other side of the fence. So that's the reason why they on the other side of the fence, because they know what they're doing. The individual gonna explode eventually. So he don't want them exploding on him. So when they explode, he gonna either kill himself, he gonna either kill another individual, or he gonna try something out the ordinary, like try to go over the fence or do anything.
Even though he knows he'd get shot going over the fence.
Even though he know he gonna get shot going over that fence, he's ready to die. He don't care. He don't care no more. Because he feels though, he say, okay, well, if I go over that fence and they shoot me down, they gonna send me to Springfield, because they know I'm, he's gone. He's just simply gone. You might just come, you might have a guy, it's just been going on real regular here. He might come out of cell and just go off on an individual for no apparent reason. He just go off on him. Can't take it no more. He can't get to the supervisory officials that's harassing him day in and day out. You know, beating him in the head with sticks. Oh, that goes on regular around here. Kicks him. Just treat him any kind of way. So when he get mad, he take his hostilities out on other individuals, inmates. So you know we're in a situation where it's a catch 22. If you want to look at it where as though okay, we done locked the system down and it's less hostilities. Okay, yeah, true. It's less hostilities on the part of staff members. That's it. You ain't gonna make conditions worse for the ones that you confined worse.
You think they'll punish you for talking to us?
Oh, in some form or another. Maybe not physically, because I know how to work that pen. But they would do it in their own way. Keep me. I might pop up sometime on another, ready to go to C unit or wherever, and they say, okay, well, we don't feel as though that you're ready to go, or this and that. You know, so I'm pretty sure that, see, the average individual, most individuals wouldn't want to talk to you. Not behind it, the fact that they don't want to talk to you, is that these people's got them so conditioned under the circumstances and to the point where as though they say, okay, well, we talk to them, then I might not make C unit. Then I might not make B unit. So they say, okay, well, we're gonna stay away from them. I'm trying to get out of here. But I can understand in certain situations.
Is there that much difference between, let's say, E unit where you are and H unit?
Oh, the difference is, that's the difference in E unit and H unit. H unit is control unit, which they call control, yeah. Which is designed specifically to do what they want to do with the entire joint. Try to control you mentally and physically at the same time. I saw all the old barricades you got around. You on individual wreck by himself. You know, they can strip you out of all your rights. You know, they all kinds of searches that's entirely unnecessary. So you gonna have guys, I've never been there, but I done heard about H unit. But you have guys over there probably trying to commit suicide more regular than you got in the regular general population.
Thanks for talking to us.
All right, thank you.
Yeah. All right, good luck. Take care, man.
When you say it's gonna be on in August?
Down wide open. What we got?
why?
Make your money another way. Check it out.
Thank you.
keep your convenience.
Tell them to close it.
Not yet.
Tell them to open it.
Come on.
shut it. Watch yourself out. Okay, let's do it.
Ready?
Let's do that. Let me interrupt you. We're we're about ready to move an inmate from the hospital.
Okay, down this hall?
Yeah, he'll be coming out this door and heading through those gates if you want to...
Yeah.
Is that door gonna stay open or is this closed?
You want this one closed?
Yeah.
Okay.
Thank you.
On the box. Open 10, 1-0.
Watch out, stretch.
Close 10.
Okay.
ethics will say that.
Oh, they're taking them over.
Oh. Booga!
Ain't nobody in here.
They don't want to do that.
Yeah, huh? Can't tell him.
Make your money another way. Check it out.
Thank you. maybe you know, get a copy so you can of that right there. And I need some working press holders. Hey, Presby.
Yeah.
And I need some. I need also some working press holders.
Okay.
And
Just these one.
Yeah, I need a copy of those. As many as you can give me.
Well, 10 o'clock can't be okay?
Yeah, it's fine. I don't need it now.
I'll get with them at 8 o'clock and get back to camp.
That's cool.
Okay, Stan.
All right.
Yeah.